Hi everybody, I'm Nichole Fecteau. I am the chairman of the Berwick Planning Board. I've served on the Berwick Planning Board for about 8 years now, also obviously a resident of the town for 20 some odd years, and a local realtor for 11 years. So I am here to talk a little bit about how to stop development in our town, because I see it an awful lot talked about online. So I wanna tell you how to stop development. First thing you could do is make a Facebook post saying you don't like it, post your opinions and its effect on your opinion effect on the town and the environment, but that's not actually gonna stop development. What you can actually do to stop development in our town and to preserve the lands, wetlands and forest and fields is there's a few things you can do. So one is that you would have to actually go to the current owner of the property. Going to the town isn't really gonna do much for you. With the Land Use Ordinance dictates what the owner can do with their own property, and there's nothing that the town can do about that. So things that an owner can do to protect their land is put it into tree growth. So in Maine, if you have 10 plus acres of forested land that could be used for commercial forestation, you can put it into tree growth and that preserves that land and it gives you a tax break. You can deed it to the town as an open space, public land. There's a lot of subdivisions that have deeded their public land and open space to the town, and so that's land that the public has access to. The Great Works Regional Land Trust also works to preserve land. They've got some parcels earmarked that they really want to preserve because of their importance in our ecosystem and watersheds. But they are able to also preserve land and they work with landowners. It's a common misconception that the land trust has a ton of money to just pay landowners for land. I actually served on the board of directors for the land trust for a bit, and they're very limited with their resources and they do work a lot on fundraising, but they are able to protect the land. Another way through the town to stop development of land would be to petition the town to rezone areas. So I'm going to talk a little bit about zoning, hopefully, if we have enough time. But this is the least likely to happen because we can't spot zone. We can't, in the middle of the R1 district, which is the downtownish area, we couldn't say this little parcel right here is spot zoned for R3. That's illegal. But it is something that could happen. And this is something that if you're really interested in it, you should look into it. And if you're very passionate about it, this is a way to change it. I did want to talk a little bit about, I know there was a little uproar recently about wetlands and development and migration of animals and whatnot. And it's all very true. The more we develop, it does push animals out of that area. Very, very true. This is why we zone the town a certain way. We've got our little urban overlay. We've got R1, so we keep the density downtown. R2, which is a transitional zone, R3, agriculture, and RCI are the outskirts of town, and that's where we try to do, you know, no urban sprawl, et cetera, et cetera. We keep the lots larger so that we preserve the rural character and the wildlife habitats. The DEP actually works to protect the wetlands through a wetland permit, so anytime there's a development, they have to go through a DEP process. And that's the National Resources Protection Act that dictates all of that. And so the law focuses, and I'm gonna read this, I'm reading from my phone because I made notes. The law is focused on protected natural resources, and a permit is required when an activity will be located in, on, or over any protected natural resource, or located adjacent to a coastal wetland, a great pond, river, stream, brook, or significant wildlife habitat contained within a freshwater wetland or certain freshwater wetlands. And then an activity, so if this activity is going on, they need this special permit, is dredging, bulldozing, removing, displacing soil, sand, vegetation, or other materials, draining or dewatering, filling, or any construction, repair, or alteration of any permanent structure. Also, if a wetland is damaged or dewatered, there's a whole process for compensating, mitigating, and restoring that, which is also regulated through the DEP. So please remember that the DEP is made up of engineers, environmental scientists, environmental engineers, inspectors, research scientists, planners, watershed specialists, analysts, hydrogeologists, water quality specialists, and more. And the town relies on their information and guidance through their tested procedures, policies, and permit process to guide the developers through that. And that's their job. So the opinions of the town and all of us, and even the planning board, are nothing compared to the science that is behind what the DEP does, and that's their deal. So rest assured that if wetlands are impacted, it is being regulated. And the other thing to keep in mind is that people buy land and real estate as an investment generally. Real estate's been one of the best investments categorically that you can invest in. And generally people are buying it to make money off of it. That's what they do. So it is hard to get landowners to protect this land without realizing their investment. So that is what I have to say about development. So the other thing I wanted to touch on very briefly is zoning and what can happen in your zone. And that brings us to the Land Use Ordinance, which you can go right online. I'm sure there's going to be a link right here that you can click on that's going to take you to our Land Use Ordinance. And you're going to want to go to page 33, 34, and so on. And you're going to see this lovely table here. So this table corresponds to our zoning map, and it tells you exactly what you can do in a zone, or what somebody else can do, more importantly, in a zone. So just to briefly go over, because it is a table and it says it's got X's and C's and A's and P's on it. So if something has a P, so for instance, in the R1 zone, single family dwellings with driveways are permitted. It's permitted in R2, R3, CI, AP, which is agricultural, LR, and SP. Permitted means you come to the town, you see our code enforcement officer, you get a permit, and you build it. You do not have to come to the planning board. You do not have to go through any other special process besides the building permit process. There is C, so cluster development. A cluster development is not allowed in R1. It is allowed in R2. And if you've been following along, you know that we've been dealing with this specifically in R2 on Pine Hill Road. And there's a C. So C means it's a conditional permit. So it's allowed, but that you have to come to the planning board and go through the process to get a conditional use permit. And that is when the planning board can actually just put conditions. We cannot deny the application or deny the project. We can just simply put conditions on it, make sure that those are adhered to. So that's what the C is. An X means something is not allowed, and an A just means that it is allowed. You don't even have to come here and talk to us. So if you look through this and you live in R1, you can see that, let's see, we can have single family homes, we can have community living arrangements, we can have congregate housing, elderly housing, mobile home parks, multifamilies, owner-occupied apartments, educational facilities. We could have a museum. We could have, let's see, we can't have a campground. We could have a drugstore. So you can go through and read this and see what people can do or what you could do with your own property. And these are very clearly laid out. It's very easy to read. It's fun. If you can't go to sleep at night, this is a great way to get some education and wind down. If you have any questions, you can always email me also. I know I put James's info up there, but as he's transitioning into the town manager, I'm happy to take emails or any calls, concerns, whatever about planning board stuff. We're meeting this Thursday at 6:30. Right here in the town hall in the Burgess meeting room, and I don't have the agenda yet, but I can guarantee you that you're about to see a screenshot of the agenda. And that's all I have for you. I'm going to do a recap next week, same time.